guys, and welcome back to Let's Play The Sims 3 Ambitions, Part 15. And as you can see, we are in our new house. I'll just kind of pause this to kind of just show you what we did. And I did this off camera. I didn't leave off where I was because I tried to record this and my game crashed and things froze up. So, you know, that kind of got a little screwed up. But, we're in our new house, and I'm not going to take you through the tour because I'd showed you this house before. The only thing I really added was a baby swing and the chemistry set to the outbuilding, and also some appliances for the kitchen like the deep fryer and the ice cream maker and the chocolate fountain. So this was the house that was done by Hello Kitty 599. I think that was the numbers after her last name, after Hello Kitty. But this is what the kitchen looks like now because of the extra appliances and stuff. You know, nothing big. But as you can see, we're pretty much broke. We don't have much money anymore. It took pretty much everything we had to get moved and all that. Anyway, so Adrian is going to go ahead and write a stakeout report because it's what she wants to do. Tony is in the baby swinging because it's something I added. Laura is going to listen to a cooking tabcast. Martin is sleeping, and as you can see, we also got some not-so-routine machines, which is good, and I turned on the sprinklers for the garden. Yeah, so that's pretty much what we're going to do. Adrian has where she has to ask Three Sims about the bistro for her case that's coming up. Yep. We'll just kind of follow Laura here. Hmm. Now, I did get, and she's going to paint something. I did get them a few lifetime rewards. Like, I got everybody Steel Bladder, Hardly Hungry, Dirt Defiant, and I think that's going to help us out a lot so we don't have to cook all the time, but y'all. Y'all. So, yep, she's going to listen to the Tapcast, and that's going to be for 54 more minutes. And we'll send her to school, and then when we get home, we will have her tend the garden. We have cooking. I think we got a cooking skill. Yep, painting skill to level 3. That's all right. Painting skill. I don't think that we have anything to pay. Because we actually did get Martin no bills ever, so I think, whoops. Yeah, between the garage and everything, yeah, I'm just going to make sure. Yep, our little flag's down, so we're very good to go. We don't have anything to pay. And we did get Martin no bills ever because we had enough lifetime points for him to do that. All right, and we got Adrian, you're supposed to write your stakeout report. Oh my goodness. And I did get them these like virtual reality goggles or whatever, so yeah. Okay, the school bus for Laura will come in about an hour. Laura has cooking skill to level 4, so she will be able to get some more recipes and stuff. Adrian. Oops. Adrian. Go home. Yes, go home, and then we'll have you write your stakeout report. Ugh. When Sims don't listen to you, I'm telling you. Her energy isn't half bad, so we're just going to let Laura paint until the carpool comes for, or not the carpool, but the school bus and all that comes for her. And then we'll just send her to school. Her motors are pretty full, so we're good. We're very good. Oops. And when Adrian gets home, we're gonna have her turn Tony's swing back on here. Mm-hmm. turn on to slow. And Laura's gonna go off to school, which is good. We'll have her work hard. That way we can maintain our grades. Oops. Go on, turn Tony's swing on here. Don't tell me that you are stuck. What the heck? All right. You go here.
Nanama!
Go on, you go here. And then we need to find Tony. Actually get up to Tony here. Oh, yeah, that's... I don't remember giving him those, like, PJs or anything. I really don't. Well, okay, Martin's up. Watch Tony. Make sure that Tony's not on fast. Yeah, change it to slow before you get him sick. I'm telling you. Come on. Before you get him sick. I hate it how they just turn it to fast because it's just... you know, that's when the kid gets really sick, you know? That's when the kid gets really sick. Adrian, we're going to have her sleep for a little bit because her energy is kind of sort of halfway down. Let's go to sleep for her. Yep. Just going to let her go to sleep. And then Martin, let's make sure he's not supposed to do... No. Make sure he's not supposed to do something he's not supposed to do. Yeah. We're going to have him actually go to his laptop, which I did get them all laptops because Adrian really needed that for her job and stuff, and I just thought this would be a little easier. We're going to have Martin continue writing The Time Traveler. Yep. We'll do that. And not too much really needs to be done right now because Adrian's going to sleep. We got some opportunities to fulfill. You know, they got to work out and stuff, but we'll just get him to come to the desk while she's sleeping. But anyway, and this will give me an opportunity to talk a little bit, but I did record a Legacy Family Challenge part, and I had my babies glitch out again, so less baby was born. I don't want to give away too much, but the baby was born. The baby was glitched again, and we had, like, the flashing stuff going on and just a weird-looking baby. So, which told me that I had some bad content again, which I'd cleaned stuff out a couple weeks ago, like, after Patricia and Yves had their babies, but something was in there. And so I just thought I would just kind of give you guys, like, a little tip from what I have discovered. If you download stuff from the exchange, because what's really notorious is, like, if Sims or households, like, if you download a Sim or a household, you could get the bad content on it that I'm about to mention. That's really notorious, but, what you're going to find and how you would find this is if you notice that your game is really glitching out and crashing and just really being goofy, is if you open up your launcher and you click on the installed content. And you're going to have to scroll through, and it's usually under CAS parts, which is Create a Sim part. And because usually it's the clothing that really causes it. So, and I'm just going to give you some names of what you can look for. The bad stuff that you would look for, and you can find it on the exchange or even any other sites that you would download a Sim from or whatever. Martin just got paid $15 for submitting a few chapters of The Time Traveler to the publisher. Okay, so some of the files that you're going to find that's really bad is if you scroll through your installed content through your launcher, new CAS project. And there's several versions of those that are downloaded that you can find in there. Get rid of those because those will really mess you up. New CAS project. Collection Blondes is really bad. Collection Blondes. And also Shymoo. S-H-Y-M-O-O is bad custom content. And there's one more. Daytime Nighttime Boots, which is like if you scroll through and see the picture, it looks like a black pair of boots. Daytime Nighttime Boots. So it's Shymoo, Daytime Nighttime Boots, New CAS Project, and Collection Blondes is really bad. Also, if you scroll through and you find something that says something like top NKD or bottom NKD. It stands for naked. And if you click on those will make your Sims naked. Okay, so for Laura, go to France and interview a local Sim, then report back to school. I guess we could do that. We gotta get some money to go, but we'll just put that on there for her. You know, we can try that. Anything that says top NKD or bottom NKD, that's like a naked thing, and that will make your Sim look really naked and just really goofy. So those are some of the bad files that you want to get rid of. And if you download a lot of Sims or households and stuff, you might want to scroll through as, you know, and off the exchange, because sometimes, you know, the exchange isn't foolproof. Scroll through that and just, you know, see what you can find, you know. The Time Traveler is going well. Submitting the last few chapters earned Martin $15. So, those are just some things that you can look for to find if you find that your game is really glitching out really badly and stuff. So I just wanted to offer that little helpful tip because, you know, just in case you guys really needed it, you know. We got a Simfest. Yep. We're just gonna get through that. I really hope that helps out some folks. I really do. And now that we're like hardly hungry and stuff, we really don't need to cook all that much. She wants to have a child. Oh, we did have a child with Martin. Oh my gosh. We're not going to have like any more kids for a while, dearie. We really are not. Huh. Laura wants to win a game against Adrian, watch a movie, hang out with Adrian, and let's see. Yep. So Adrian is up and she's actually going to work out, which means that she's going to fulfill her little opportunity here. We're going to push self. So we're going to let her do that. Oops. Laura is still at school. When she gets home, we'll have her turn Tony here back on. Let's just see how Tony's doing. Yeah. We'll have her turn Tony back on. We want her to do her homework because she needs to do that. Now, when I was having a move, and I did this off camera, but when I was having them move, where is her tablet? Here's her tablet. No. When I was, oh, okay. Laura doesn't have any homework. When I was having them move, it said Laura got caught out after curfew, and so there's like, come with me, young lady. So yeah, but that was just because we were moving and we kind of moved at night. So it was kind of like a weird thing. All right, we don't really need to tend the garden, so we're going to, let's see what kind of recipes and, well, we can get her some recipes and stuff because, she needs, she can read some fruit parfait when she gets home, and then we'll get her some, then we'll shop online for some recipes because she is going to need that, and we could have her discover some potions and all that good stuff. So we'll shop online for some books, and we got everybody like the bookshop bargainer because, they needed that. Yep. They needed that because with as much books and stuff as they get, we'll have Laura learn fruit parfait, and then we will, I think maybe we'll have her learn some piano. So Adrian's just going to work out. Look at Laura. She's on the little motorcycle because we actually had a motorcycle in our garage for this house. So it looks like she's gonna ride the motorcycle. We'll get her to turn Tony on here. All right. Yep, you sit and read that. Now, we've got I think we got a thing for a skill challenge here. He just completed a skill achievement and write. Okay, yeah. Sometimes some memories get a little annoying, like the memory sharing thing, but it's kind of like how you keep your wall active, I guess. Okay, so Martin has written enough books in a single genre to complete the Specialist Writer Skill Challenge. Check Martin's journal, blah, 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 blah. Okay, Martin. Martin's new science fiction novel, The Time Traveler, aims for an excitement of a blockbuster summer movie, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so he will receive 234... in royalty payments every week, and it will be delivered on Sunday. So what we're going to have him do, we'll come back and have him actually write some more. Let's see. He can... Looks like he's got the one laptop in his inventory here. So we'll just... And we, like I said, we actually did get everybody laptops. So writing, let's go ahead and write a fantasy novel. Now, I think what we're going to go ahead and do is, like when I showed the Lancasters, I actually, what I did was I actually had Catherine start to write the Harry Potter books. But what we're going to do with Martin is we're going to have him write the Inheritance series. Like, let's see, Stephanie's Book of Sweets. We're actually going to have him write the Elvis series, like Aragon and Brisinger and all that good stuff. And which are books written by Christopher Paolini. And it's a fantasy series about a boy who, finds a dragon egg and he befriends this dragon, and they got to kind of, you know, do the Armageddon battle, you know, good versus evil and all that stuff. But it's a really good series. If you haven't read it, I would recommend it if you like to read. I really like it a lot. So the first book in it is called Aragon, E-R-A-G-O-N. And as I said, you know, the books are written by Christopher Paolini. And yeah, they're just very good. Adrian's still working out. So we'll fulfill her opportunity here soon. So Laura's just going to read, and Martin is just going to write his little zip, book. Zip, Laura, zip. I think, almost has her recipe memorized. Yeah. Well, she's starting to get really tired. We'll probably send her to bed maybe kind of soon, but it's kind of halfway down in the green. But we're going to turn her into a gardener because... we've got our garden. Okay, Laura just learned how to make fruit parfait. Delicious. Oh my goodness. All right, so we're going to shop online for some books. Let's do some recipes here. And maybe we'll do some sheet music as well. We may know a lot of these. I'm not sure. I am not sure what we got. But we do have Bookshop Bargainer, so we're just going to get some Baked Angel food cake, stuffed turkey, stuffed toy soiki, tri-tip steak, tri-tip vegetarian steak, blah, 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 and I'm reading them backwards. Eggs Machiavellian. Let's get rid of this one because we don't need two of them. Yep. All right. Eggs Machiavellian. Cobbler. Cheese steak. Cheese tofu steak. Fried peanut butter and banana sandwich. We know fruit parfait. So, I guess that's all we're gonna need to get, really. Oops, we can't get that. No, we're not gonna be able to do that, because we gotta get some more money. Oh my, we gotta get some more money. Oh, sorry, Laura. We're kind of screwed with that. We'll just get a couple of them, I guess. Fried peanut butter banana sandwich and cheese steak. I guess we'll do that. It's going to take away a lot of our money. Let's see what we can read here. We can't read any of that. Let's go ahead and listen to a... Oh, let's go ahead and do her homework, because we do need to do that. Actually, I want to do it on the tablet. I want to have her do it on the tablet. So we're going to do her homework. Yep, do your homework. And that'll get it done really, really fast. See if there's anything we need to do with the garden. We'll have her tend the garden when she's done with that. Is her homework done? No, before you tend the garden, you need to do that homework. Go on, do homework first. You get done with it in a jiffy. Yep, in a jiffy. Oops. I didn't mean to pause that like that. All right, so she's done with that. Now let's go ahead and have her come out and tend the garden. Whoops. Tend the garden. Because we're going to get some gardening skillet for her. Now what we're going to go ahead and do, and I tend to do this a lot with the gardening thing, because the stuff just goes so slow. Like the needs will just really, 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 really go down. Okay, so Adrian, nice. Now you have something to show off when the paparazzi take photos of you at the pool. Okay, so she's got 500 celebrity points, Adrian does, because we fulfilled the opportunity. So she is a 3-star celebrity. But with the gardening, I tend to no matter what I'm doing, I mean, I tend to move the sliders, like the hygiene sliders and the fun sliders and the energy sliders, just kind of up, because it really does take a toll on the person that's doing the gardening. So we're gonna, you know what, I normally don't do this. I really normally do not do this, like in an LP, but for gardening I do, and I know I've explained that to you guys before. I have explained that to you guys before, so I will, okay, so, yeah, it just said that she harvested some stuff. So we're just gonna let her do that. We'll just let her do that, and we'll get this garden done here. Yep, we'll get the garden done here. Tony, let's just see how Tony's doing. Tony is getting a little hungry, and Tony needs some social. Oh my. Oh. Okay. Martin, you're gonna have to go and play with your son here. We're going to. We're going to have to give him a bottle. Yep. Yep, we got to take care of our son. Come on, get him. Get him, get him. And then, yep, he definitely needs some social, so We're gonna play with him, and we're going to snuggle him. We're going to play with him. We're gonna snuggle him. And I do this on pause because they move so much, and it's really hard to get a good click on them whenever they're moving all the time. So we'll do that.
Good bossy.
Yep. So we're just gonna go ahead and have him play with Tony here. Tony's hunger is definitely going up. And and Tony's bladder is going to go down, so we will we'll just kind of and his social is going way up, so we're just going to let him just kind of play with Tony a little bit. And then we'll change the diaper when he's ready here. Okay. And Tara's doing blah blah blah, so she's got like a gardening thing here. But we're just gonna make sure that we've got the sliders turned up for her all the way so that she can make sure she gets through the garden. Like I said, I normally don't do that, but for gardening I do because there's just really no way of getting around it. Alright, come on, Tony, pee your britches. Okay, Laura has gardening to level 2, and she will master this gardening very much so because, between Tabcast and, actually doing it, we're gonna keep playing with Tony here. Let's play with him. Let's snuggle him until he pees, and then we can change his diaper. Play with. Snuggle him. And then when he pees his diaper, then we'll change it, and we'll put him back in the swing. Okay. We'll have him do that. Tony will pee himself, and then the hygiene will go down here. So then we'll have him change the dirty diaper when he's done with that. And then Tony can go back into the swing. Martin's starting to get a little tired. Alright. Laura has gardening to level 3. That's very good. Alright, so then Martin, we're going to have him just, and I know I'm kind of pausing it just a little bit here, but I need to click on the swing. Let's go ahead and turn it on to slow. And we're going to go ahead and send Martin to bed. He's not super duper hungry or anything yet, but that will just kind of help a bit. And Adrian's kind of tired too, so we're just going to go ahead and send these two to bed. And Laura's doing all this gardening, like, and she's like this teenager doing all this gardening. There's kind of something not right about that, is there? But, you know, hey, when they develop their interest, sometimes they really develop their interest. So I'm just going to keep her sliders at full while she does this garden so that we can try to get through it. Because I want her to become a nectar maker as well. And then we can actually go to the consignment store. And we can actually sell nectar and stuff because, you know, when she gets, like, really good at it and stuff, you know, then we can do that. New home for moodlets. Yep, squeaky clean. And having a blast is because I moved her sliders. But the consignment store, you know, they can actually sell their nectar and anything that they make. You know, for a price and all that. And I think the consignment store did come with Ambitions, with Twinbrook. So that would kind of definitely be part of what Ambitions is about. Also, self-employment came with Ambitions. Now what I did, what I did in order to get this house put down was I ended up having to evict the Bakers, because Twin Brook kind of sucks with trying to put new things down, because they don't really offer many lots and stuff to do that with. So you got to kind of go into Edit Town and you've got to remove some things if you want to, you know, kind of play with it a little bit, because it's pretty full, Twin Brook is at that. So otherwise if you plop down a lot like from the World Maker, it goes on a hill and then it looks really, really bad. So yeah, it's not exactly the funnest thing, but what do you do? So we kicked out the Bakers, which is a family that came from Twin Brook, and we put this one down. So, yep. So we're just kind of messing with the garden here. And she will have to go to school the next day. We're just going to keep an eye on that as she does that. So yeah, her hygiene and her fun goes down. Also, the energy goes down when you do that. And Martin and Adrian are going to be up pretty soon. How's Tony doing? Tony's squeaky clean. We'll just keep an eye on that. Laura, I think, got gardening skill to level 4. Now, she will master this really well. Now, I think what I may do, as long as I am here, we might just have room enough to put down some trees of prosperity, which would be very nice. Let's just see if we've got the room here. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. That came with Lunar Lakes, and you have to have Lunar Lakes to be able to have that. So I'm going to go ahead and put that down, and I will be right back. Okay, actually, I cannot do that right now because we don't have enough money, so... And I don't want to use a cheat, so we're just gonna have to wait. We're gonna have to wait till we earn some money. Because getting our nice new house kind of took its toll on us. Indeedy it did. Okay, Adrian's gonna get up. So we're gonna have her just come and take care of Tony here. We're going to go ahead and give him a bottle. That way we keep Tony happy.
Oh, bad news.
All right.
Tula.
We'll have her play with him. We'll have her snuggle him. We'll have her play with him. We'll have her snuggle him. We'll have her play with him. And snuggle him. And then we'll put him into the swing. We've got to do her case as well. I think Martin's up too. No, we're not going to study architectural design. He can come over here and make this bed. And then I think we'll continue on his book here.
Woohoo! Yeah!
Writing, he can continue with Aragon. And then, we don't want to do it fast, though. No. Change speed to slow. Yep, change it to slow. And then, um, She's sore and fatigued. She's having a blast. Let's see how Laura's doing with the gardening stuff here. We're just going to move that up to full. Okay. Now, Adrienne, what we need to have her do, because she wanted to write a stick-out report, we're gonna go ahead and let her do that and see what kind of recipes that she can learn, too. So, and we need to get her on her case. Investigator, write stakeout report. You do that. Oh, she's sneaking here. No, we need to come down and write our stakeout report. Well, actually, we could, and she's sneaking again. Did you guys see that? Did you guys totally see that? We could actually just go into the outbuilding, I guess, and just do it that way, because Martin's at the one desk. So, Adrienne, just can investigator and write stakeout report. We'll just have her go out to the little outbuilding to do that. Yep. And she's sneaking. Look at her. Like, anything you tell her to do with, like, the investigator thing, and she sneaks. She sneaks. Yep. We'll move up Laura's sliders. That way she can finish up her gardening. She's still doing that. She's going to have to go to school later on. We'll just see what, see what she can do here. And Adrienne's just going to go ahead and do that, which will fulfill a lifetime happiness point here. And then we could actually have her come and discover a potion, because she, or no, we could actually have her listen to a logic podcast. That was on the scribbling tab, which we don't need to do that. Here's her tablet. I have a mod. Let me just get her logic thing going up here. Logic. Okay. So I have a mod which is a scribbling pad object, which if your family cannot afford a computer, if they're really dirt poor, then they can do writing on it and all that good stuff. So, yep. It's just kind of a nice little mod. So she wants to improve her logic skill. And Tony, let's see. Don't know what. Oh, this is Tony's toy here, which came with Generations. Give Cuddles a new name. Let's give a girl's name. How about let's call her What do we want to call her? How about let's call her Holly, I guess. Yep. Yep, we'll call her Holly. And Tony's doing okay, so. Okay, it's almost Laura's birthday, blah, blah, blah. She will age up into an adult, young adult. And it's Tony's birthday, okay, today. So the school bus for Laura will arrive in about an hour. So she's not going to be able to get through all of the garden, but. Okay, Adrienne has just improved logic skill to level 4. martial artist, blah, 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 blah. All right, Laura, get to school. You gotta go. You've got to go, my friend. You can work hard. Yep. Okay, good. We've got Tony turned on to slow. That's very good. Now, what we should do is we should, you know, go and try to find some folks here because, we've got to interview, like, three Sims for her case. Ah, let's visit the pigeon household. And we can ask some Sims about our, bistro. She's kind of hungry, too. We can go out and get her something to eat. Maybe go to the casino at 2 o'clock or something. So, yep, we'll visit this household. I think they're, like, one of the richest families here. Yeah, I think they're, like, one of the richest families here. Okay, here we go. This is, Billy Pigeon. Let's go ahead and do, let's do a friendly introduction. And then we'll ask about the bistro to this person here.
I'm Rookie, oui.
You're supposed to ask about the bistro. Come on. The heck? Gosh. All right. Adrian just grasped the basics of martial arts. That's like sharing memories, da 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 da. Oh, just learned that Billy is rich. Well, of course. Martin submitted a few chapters of Aragon to the publisher and earned $45. Okay, so he's got some writing skill, looks like. The report is finished and I've sent it to the police. Okay, blah, 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 blah. Yep. All right.
Zuba. Jima Zuba.
Okay. All right, let's see what it said here. Asking about the bistro thingy. The bistro is a fine place to eat. I've got no complaints. Okay, so let's see if there's anybody else here to look at their house. This is the pigeon's house. Yeah, look at their house. Oh my goodness. They got a nice house. All right, we're gonna go and visit someone else. Oh, we can't visit the Racket household because nobody's there. They're like all criminals anyway. Dennis Racket and Silver and all that good stuff. We can't go there either. Well, let's find someplace else to go to here. Well, let's see if there's anybody at the hospital, and we'll see if we can ask anybody there. Get rid of the little goggles there. Okay, look at her car. All right, let's see if anybody's here. Usually, like, when we go to have a baby or something, there's always somebody there. She's all sneaking again. And I don't see anybody here. I do not see anybody there. Well, let's figure somewhere else to go to here, because we got to find, like, two more. Let's go to the bistro, I guess. Because she's kind of getting a little hungry. Let's go ahead and eat here alone, and then we'll see what we can find. No, we don't want to join medical career. No. No. I didn't tell her to do that. Not that I remember. I just told her to visit. Okay, here we go. There's some folks to ask, I guess. There's some people, but we'll let her go in and eat, I guess. And she's like snaking in.
Oh, Havali!
She's gonna just get a little chow. Okay. Alright. For Adrian. Present check. Yep, we can do that. Alright, so let's go ahead and ask. When she comes out, we'll go ahead and ask about the bistro. Finish up. That'll get her hunger mood thing up. Oh, there's a vampire, too. There's a few people that we can talk to. Ask about the bistro. Martin just got paid $45 for submitting a few chapters of Aragon.
That'll lie me, Rhonda.
Well. Oh. Invited to a party. Alright. Get rid of all that. Ask about the bistro.
Cheap Johnny Safari, see?
Oh.
Here.
Woohoo!
La divina.
And then ask about the bistro.
Cribalorts. Krimlak. Rukama.
Okay, so the bistro. Okay. I'll read that in just a minute. Eat at the bistro, which we just did. Oh my goodness. All right. She's going to end up being really stuffed. The dance is at 8 p.m. Better hurry and get ready. Okay. So I guess Laura's going to go to prom. Adrian has earned job experience. Okay. The bistro is a fine place to eat. Blah, blah, blah. Oh, I went home with a nasty case of food poisoning. The last time I ate at the bistro was, which is odd because the chef typically takes such care with the food. Okay, so I think we're gonna send Adrian over to the casino and we're gonna see if we can win some money. All right, here it is. We're going to visit the Lucky Simoleon. And then we need to get Laura ready for her dance. Oops. Oh gosh, we gotta take care of Tony here. Yep. All right, so Laura's taking care of Tony. We gotta see how her needs are doing here. She needs a shower. We'll have to do her homework like over the weekend. Let's see what Tony needs. Oh, Tony needs some social. So we're just gonna have Laura just play with him, snuggle him, play with him, snuggle him. Yep. Have big sister take care of you here. Play with, snuggle, play with, and then we'll put him back in the swing in a little bit.
What? Blugla.
Put him in the swing.
What's that, baby?
The one Sunday.
That will help.
Aww. Blugla.
Yep. All right. Let's go ahead and have her turn it on to slow. And then she needs a shower. You go take your shower. And then, Adrian, we're going to have her play some slots, I think. We'll get here on the slot machine. Let's do some, for some high stakes. Yep, we'll do that. And we'll have to get Laura ready for her dance. Oof. Tony was, like, swinging in midair for a little bit. It's taking a minute for it to load. And Martin is, he's still writing his book. But he's kind of getting a little hungry. And congratulations, Martin. Martin's just improved his writing skill to level 8. But he is getting a little hungry. By a water slide. Maybe we could do that. Go to a dive bar. No. So. Oh, he's stressed out. Nicely decorated. And comfy. He needs to have like a little bit of fun. Yep. Totally needs to have a little bit of fun too. But we're going to eat leftovers. Let's have him eat some ratatouille. Then he can play some computer games. Yeah, because his friend is pretty well not doing very great. Okay, Laura is... Yep. She's going to go to prom. We'll see if she's got some kind of a crush on someone here. But let's see what she looks like. And this is her formal wear. Yep, so she's going to go ahead and go to prom. And we'll just come back over here to Adrian and see how she's doing.
Buddy.
Flexno! Hacha! Yipa! Hua!
I don't think she's winning or anything right now. Oh! She's losing. Oh, having a blast. Great meal. Feeling lucky, though. Oh, Laura just took a ride in a limo, so... Oh, I don't know what happened to all my pictures, but we'll just... Yes. We're going to share memories here.
Carry.
All right.
Oh, Chimaka! Oh, woo!
Steve. Nope. Steve-a-lack.
Not winning anything right now. See how Martin's doing here.
Really do.
Pusha!
Woo! Okay, Martin, you gotta get your fun up, buddy. Okay, so we're winning some stuff. Okay, I think we have some skills. Congratulations, Adrian has just improved her gambling skill to level 4. Oh, Laura was tearing up the dance floor when they announced she was prom queen. Oh my gosh, that is so awesome. Everyone high-fived her as she ran up to accept the crown. Oh, okay, so we need to attend her party. We'll go ahead and attend her party. And she just went to the prom. Okay. All right. So.
Hey.
Yee-haw! Hoo-ah! Oh! Woo! Galasha!
Okay, so we're gonna get off of that because we did win some money. And she's like sneaking. Oh my gosh, she is like totally sneaking. Alright. Martin, we need to. His fun level still isn't great, and his energy is not great either. So we're gonna maybe see if we can have a little bit of fun with Tony, because both of them, I think, need a little bit of social. So let's hold Tony. Let's give him a bottle. And then we need to,
Oh, BB Soba Doo.
That will help with the social. Go ahead and play with him. Let's, snuggle him. Let's play with him. Let's snuggle him. Let's play with him. Let's snuggle him. And that's helping getting Martin's thing up going real well. And Tony's hungry. Oh! Oh, gosh! Tony's aging up! Tony is aging up. Okay, the days have flown by, blah, 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 blah. Tony's a toddler. Alright. Okay, Betty's hungry, so I think what we're going to go ahead and do, he's going to go ahead and pick him up and stuff.
Oh, the new boo. Oh, my father. Whoa. Oh, new boo. Oh, boo-za-boo.
Oh, there's Tony. We need to change his appearance, too. Let's go ahead and feed on the floor. We'll see how Adrian's doing at the party here. She's like sneaking. Alright. So we're driving. We're gonna attend Billy Pigeon's party here. We need to talk to some people. She's still sneaking. Look at her. Look at her. Unbelievably crazy. That is just nuts. So we're gonna go and be chatted to, I guess. Come on. Who's this? Okay, so this is Bobby Sargent. So we're just going to do a greet celebrity here.
Yelgit.
Naba.
Oh, okay. We're just gonna chat with him a little bit. Ask about alma mater. We'll just kind of chat just a little bit here. Friendly chat. I'm getting all this lined up because because we need to, let's see, we're going to enthuse about new house because we need to, you know, just make sure that, Martin is, taking care of Tony. Let's tell a funny story. Might even help get her charisma up. And then let's just chat some more. See how Tony's doing here. Oh, Tony needs a diaper change. You get up, Martin. You change the dirty diaper. Change dirty diaper. And then we need to potty train him and all that good stuff. Then we can just put everyone to bed, I guess. Come on, Martin, get up. Get up. Get up. Get up. You get up. Did Laura come back? Do homework. Yep, Laura came back. So she had, I guess, had a good time at the prom. Okay, he's taking quite a liking to Holly, so we need to get Holly to play. Okay, the school dance has ended. You might want to head home before you get in trouble with blah, 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 blah. Laura's curfew is in 1 hour. Okay, so... Okay, Laura thought the backdrop for prom pictures looked amazing. Decorations are incredible. Laura feels like she's actually under the sea. So we're gonna get Laura to come home and do her homework. Oh, actually, she is home, I think. Yep.
So, poor Blue Nose.
She's just gonna go ahead and do her homework and. We'll get Martin to put Tony in the swing. My dogs are going nutso. So we're going to turn it on to slow. And we're just going to have Martin just go to sleep. And I think this will be a good place to end the part. Because we've recorded for quite a while. And, ooh, Adrienne's gonna pass out and croak here. We'll put her to sleep. And Laura, we're just gonna let her, she's just doing her homework right there. And so, yep, I'm just gonna go ahead and end the part. We're just gonna get everyone put to bed. So, and then that will be a good place to just cool our heels for the night. So I'm going to go ahead and end the part. Like I said, you guys have a simtastic day. Favorite and like this video. Give it a thumbs up and let me know what you think. Let me know if there's anything that you would particularly like to see in this series. If you want to see more, subscribe to my channel. You can know when, if you do that, then you can know pretty soon when I'm going to upload a video. It'll show you when I've uploaded a video. And Adrienne's sneaking again. You can be pretty early to watch it if you subscribe, because you'll know when one is uploaded. You'll be able to see my current LPs plus my future LPs, which will be Seasons and Supernatural, which will be coming up very soon, as soon as the launch days come for them, which Supernatural will be out in a couple of weeks. So I will see you guys in the next LP. And as I said, have a fantastic day, and we'll talk to you guys all later. Okay, bye guys.